वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू विथ अवर चैप्टर 7 एंड द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ आर्स इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ। हाउ कैन वी कंजर्व फॉरेस्ट? सो देर आर फ्यू यू कैन से द गाइडलाइंस और द एफर्ट्स विच वी शुड टेक टू प्रोटेक्ट फॉरेस्ट, टू कंजर्व द फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ। एंड द फर्स्ट यू कैन से एफर्ट इज protection by law. It is very necessary that there should be strict laws, and laws should be made, and their enforcement, that is, they are to be followed strictly for the protection of and forest and the preservation of wildlife. And the laws could be like no hunting, right? There will be no cutting of trees allowed. So all those strict rules are should be followed. Then the next point could be afforestation. What do you mean by afforestation? Means planting of trees. If we have a need of tree, if we cut one tree, then 5 more trees should be planted, right? Then third could be protection from forest fires. Fires in the forest, like natural or human activities. If whatever could be the reason, but forest fires should be controlled, right? By spraying of extinguishers from the aircrafts, or you can say changing the direction of winds. There can be many, many efforts to be taken. Then the fourth could be personal and society effort. Like the, you can say, joint programs like Van Mahotsav, and all those should be taken every month by the society to conserve our forest. Then habitat preservation. Habitat preservation means the protected areas, like such as wildlife sanctuaries or national parks. They should be established and maintained very well to conserve our wildlife. They should be given their natural habitat so that their species could grow well, and they could be even protected also. Okay, so for conservation of forest and wildlife, we are supposed to take many efforts, and if we start, then only our future will be having all these species and will be having a fruitful life. Otherwise, due to all these consequences of deforestation, our future will not be as fruitful, as clean environment as we have today. Okay, so now our next topic is biosphere reserve. Now, what do you mean by biosphere reserve? Biosphere reserve, biosphere is the part of the earth in which living organism exist, or you can say on where life is being support, that is biosphere. Now, what is biosphere reserve? It is a large area protected, right? Large area of land, and it is meant for conservation of wildlife and biodiversities, where traditional lifestyle of tribal people could be living in that area will be maintained, right? It could be divided into, you can say, three zones. Where first is where tribal or integral part of biosphere reserve, which is a special feature, right? It manages the biodiversity and even the economic activity also. So the biosphere reserves, they are very large areas where the animals will be given their natural habitat, and they will be protected in that area. They will be allowed to grow, and they will be safe also over there. It is not only the wildlife, you can say both flora and fauna, because we have many species, even of plants and animals both, which are in the endemic stage, right? Which are the endemic species, which are in danger, we can say endangered species also and endemic species also. So we are supposed to conserve both flora and fauna. Now, children, do you know what is flora and fauna? Flora means plants and fauna means animals. Right, so human activities, not only you can say it's dangerous for animals, it is also dangerous for few species of plants also. Through human activities, there are many plant species also which have become endangered. Right, so this biosphere reserves, this can contain both flora and fauna for their conservation. There are many wildlife sanctuaries in our country, and the main wildlife sanctuaries, you can say not only biosphere reserves but wildlife sanctuaries and national parks, they are nowadays being handled by government also, and they are taking care to preserve our flora and fauna both. So these are the few pics you can say of our endemic species. Now, what do you mean by endemic species? Do you know what is endemic species? Endemic species means they are the species of plants and animals which are found specially in that particular area. They are exclusively a part of that particular area. They are naturally found over there. Anywhere else, they won't be found naturally. But I am not talking about zoo. In zoo, we will be allowed to see many species, different species of animals, right? But that we are getting it from different places and we have accumulated them at a single place for visitors to view. But endemic species are those species which occur naturally in that specified area only. For example, you can say Panchmarhi Biosphere Reserve. It is having a plant named sal, or you can say wild mango. So these trees you can see in Panchmarhi Biosphere Reserve only. Right? For example, of animals, if we say Indian giant squirrel, flying squirrel, right? They are found in that area only. Naturally, they occur over there itself. Right, so this endemic species, they may even vanish in our near future, like they may disappear in our near future because of the destruction of their habitat. If we destruct their habitat, if we destruct their biosphere reserve, then this species will be converted to endangered species, which will be about to complete in their existence. उनका existence ही ख़त्म हो जाएगा अगर हम ये species को conserve नहीं करेंगे. उनको अपने area और habitat जो उनको चाहिए वो हम अगर उनको provide नहीं करेंगे, जो natural उनको habitat चाहिए तो. Right, so that is meant by endemic species. And about wildlife sanctuaries and national parks and other all topics, we will be continuing in our next part of the video.